life. Warm greetings to you students out there at home. The message is you need to stay focused. Observe all the SOPs. Stay safe and wait for the time when you will be called back for face-to-face studies. During the time when you are at home, we shall keep on having online lessons, and where necessary, we shall have video clips that can be sent to you for viewing, and then later on, we shall get the comments from your side. I am Kawewo John Bosco, by name, and a teacher of physics and mathematics. During the discussions we shall be handling, as far as senior one is concerned, I will give much attention to the side of mathematics and leave physics for my colleagues to take on. Now, being a competence-based curriculum in senior one, we shall make use of the learner's guide. I'm very sure many of you people have accessed the learner's book guide. Some of you people have a copy in soft form, or else you may have a hard copy. If you look at the learner's guide, you will realize that Senior 1 has 12 topics gazetted for Senior 1 work. Some of these topics we handled at the time during the time before the lockdown, and others were handled just before the second lockdown. As I'm talking now, my attention is going to go to topic number 6. Topic number 6, where we have sequence and patterns. For some of you people who have access to the learner's guide, that's the learner's book. It is on page 71. If you open, you clearly see what I'm talking about. We are going to look at sequence and then patterns. These two are related. When we talk about sequence and patterns, they are related. In the first place, when you talk about a pattern, the pattern we shall always try to look at the regular or repeated way of doing something. Regular or repeated way of doing something. And these patterns are common in real life situations. Some of you people have ever used the patterns. For example, some people lock their mobile phones, and to open up, you need to use the pattern. The pattern can be in the form of any shape, can be a letter, but the fact is that you have to use it regularly and repeatedly. Whenever you use it, you will open up your phone. There are people who lock computers. To open up the computer, and you need the pattern. You may use the pattern, you may use the password. Another example can be for the case of a briefcase. People have briefcases which can be locked. And to lock it, you have to enter a given number. That given number will be used repeatedly, and it will be in form of a pattern. So these patterns that we are talking about find wide application in their life situations, and we do believe you can have as many examples as possible. Think about 5 more situations where we can use the pattern, and then you will try to relate to what we are talking about in mathematics. On the other side, if you talk about a sequence appears in the form of the order in which we do things. The order of doing things can bring us to the sequence. The sequence can at times appear as a group of things, one coming after the other. You need to understand the relationship between pattern and sequence. In most cases, the pattern can give rise to a sequence. When you talk about group of things, one coming after the other, they may have a given pattern that brings one after the other. That's where we come to sequence and patterns. Good enough, in primary, in fact, the mathematics we look at in secondary, is a continuation of primary work. All the topics you are going to study, all the ones that you have so far covered in this senior one, you must have realized that they are giving you revision work of primary six, primary seven, meaning that you don't have to worry. We are going on with the same mathematics, only to say that this time we are giving you more challenges that you can handle and then develop you in terms of mathematical skills. So you just have to feel at home. I now have to talk about patterns. How do you go on and then generate a pattern? Generating a pattern is mainly using two ways. You can use a table, and sometimes we can use objects and arrange them. The first thing I'm going to talk about is how you can generate a pattern by using objects. The objects I'm going to talk about will now be in the form of crosses. If we use crosses, we can have them and they give us a certain pattern. For example, if we talk about triangle numbers, triangle numbers have their own pattern that brings out a triangle. So that one is the shape. The shape is the one that brings us to the pattern of the triangle. How do we go about this? If you use a cross, one cross can bring you to the shape of a triangle. So one is a triangle number. Next to that, if you use the two, two crosses cannot make a triangle. If you, for instance, use this, there's no way these ones can form a triangle. However, if you bring in another cross, the shape of the triangle still will be coming. And you now look at the three as a triangle number. If we involve the fourth cross, it may not bring it out clear. However, if you build and add other three crosses here, still the triangle will be coming. If you count them, they will give you six. Six is a triangle number. And you try to look at as many as possible. By the end of it all, you will have numbers generated by using a pattern in the form of shape of a triangle. So please, whenever we're talking about the patterns, we can use objects and use different arrangements to see how the patterns can come out. This is as far as the triangle is concerned. In fact, from here, we can generate another one and see what is the relationship between the consecutive triangle numbers. If I'm to look at another one, I will add other crosses and then generate that this will clearly show you that the next triangle number is 10. Not only triangle numbers, we can even talk about rectangle numbers. We can talk about square numbers. Away from this, let us try to look at it. Let's try to talk about square numbers. Examining using objects or crosses, we can soon try to talk about numbers which can form the shape of a square. For instance, if I have one, still can give me a square where all sides are equal. So one is a square number. If I go to four crosses, the four crosses can still bring out the shape of a square. I talk about 4 as a square number. If I leave 4 and go to 9, if I use 9 crosses, the 9 crosses will still bring out the shape of a square, lines the square number. So we are talking about the patterns. The patterns can be generated using a way of objects, and we arrange, or at times we can go to table. In the learner's book, that learner's book we are talking about, there is a table. A table that can assist us to identify the patterns, different patterns that we can talk about. So please, we are going to make relations for the connection from patterns to sequences. What we need to understand is that the numbers in a pattern, when arranged and organized in a given order, they give us a sequence. So a sequence in most cases comes from a pattern. And if you are to understand the sequence properly, you need to first of all study and look at which pattern is used when generating the numbers in a sequence. When we talk about a sequence, a sequence is formed using numbers, and each of the numbers in the sequence is called a term. So we shall try to talk about the first number in the sequence, first term. Second number in the sequence, second term. Third term, fourth term. So those numbers. Now what is important that we are supposed to look at is how can you look at the sequence, study the sequence, identify the pattern used, and that pattern can assist you to get other numbers, other members of the sequence. That is where we are going. Now, looking at triangle numbers, we can come to a sequence of triangle numbers where we shall have 1, 3, 6, 10, 21. That is the sequence. 1 is the first term, 3 is the second term, 6, third term, 10, fourth term, onwards. A sequence is supposed to be an infinite set. Does not end. It goes on continuously. That means it is upon you to talk about second term, third term, fourth term, etc. But the sequence goes on endlessly. Now, if you are to generate the other terms in this sequence, you can use the number patterns as well. They can take you and you get as many as possible. If you are talking about square numbers can give us now a sequence. The sequence for square numbers, the sequence for square numbers will be, the first one is 1, the second one is 4, the third term is 9. If you go on properly, you will realize that in these ones are endless. You cannot exhaust all of them. You cannot exhaust them. This is an infinite set. It goes on. Now, when starting sequences, we need to look at which one should be the rule, the general used when getting 1, the next one, following term, and continue. Now, this is not in the learner's book, but still, when I display it here, you can come to see how this can be done, and they connect it to the sequence, and how you can get the next term. For this sequence, I've given you 3 terms, but whenever you are, you can look at the diagram you can draw and get the fourth term in the sequence for these square numbers. It will be clear and you will try to understand it. Now, away from patterns here, we can draw a table. A table can be clearly seen. Going down to the table. There's that table there, seen clearly. That table is for numbers running from 1 up to 100. When you look at it properly, you will see it is also forming a square. Okay? So sometimes we talk about number square because that square has numbers, and from the properties of a square, you have to realize that all sides must be equal. Now, what's the point now? This is a table that can assist us to look at the patterns of numbers. In that table, some numbers are factors of given numbers. You may find multiples of given numbers. We may have prime factors. So in a table like that one there, we can still have sequence generated. For instance, in this very table, clearly seen, you have to see that some numbers have been shaded. You, as a student of mathematics now, you can look at the relationship of the numbers shaded and identify what they share in common. What they share in common can now give us the name. We shall have access to some other tables. But for this very table, when you look at the numbers that are shaded, they are all multiples of 4. The multiples of 4 are clearly seen shaded. And when we are talking about the sequence showing multiples of 4, multiples of 4. When multiples of 4, you can see we have 4, we have 8, 12, 16, onwards. In that table, it goes on up to 100, because we have used that square table from 1 up to 100. Now, what does this mean? Sometimes when using a table, you can look at the pattern and get the sequence, such that you try to understand which one is the next term, after getting the previous one. That one is clearly seen. Now, wherever you are, look at the table again and use it to identify all the multiples of 3. Multiples of 3. You list all of them. Sometimes we advise you to write them in the form of a set. Multiples of 3. These are multiples of 3, but the sequence will be clearly the same. Multiples of 3, you are now looking at for numbers from 1 up to 100. But does not mean that these ones are the only multiples of 4. We may have some other multiples away from this, but in this very table, that is the limit that we have taken. Now, we can try to look at the sequences and look at how you can get the next term. Getting the next term is very easy. Study the sequence and identify the pattern. Sometimes the pattern can be mathematical. It may not be mathematical in the sense that we are talking about multiples, and you go on looking at times 1, times 2, times 3, onwards. We may talk about factors of a number, and you are looking at those ones in that order. So if you have completed a sequence, you only need to identify the pattern used, and it will guide you on how you can go on and get the rest of the numbers. Let us give an example of how this can be done, identifying the pattern of the sequence and using it to find the numbers. in the teachers, in the learners' book, that book you have, there are some examples that you are going to refer to, but let us first of all have this in consideration. That example I will try to write it, but in some other examples I want to refer you to a page and you take from that book. If you look at this, in the very first example here, what we can see, we have a sequence with only three terms given. But now if you have three or more terms, they are just enough for you to identify which one is the pattern. How can you identify the pattern? To identify the pattern, in most cases, you can identify it by way of looking for the difference between these terms. The difference can give, if it brings you to a common term, a common value, then that one will be the one to add. And you come up with the rest. In this example, if you say 17 minus 12, the difference is 5. 22 minus 17, that difference is 5. That means in this sequence, it is easy. You just go on adding 5 to get to the next number in the sequence. And here, you will have you will have 12, 17, 22. Then 22 plus 5 gives 27. Then from 27 plus 5, we come to 32. 32 plus 5 gives 37. So we can say, if they say, what are the next three numbers in the sequence? The next three are 27, 32, 37. How do we come to realize that? By getting the difference between the numbers. The common difference can assist us in getting the next numbers in that sequence. Also, look at this. Another sequence with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 terms have been given. The 5 terms given can assist you to identify which one is the pattern. Now, the pattern can be by way of looking at the difference. Now, looking at the difference between these numbers, it will be clear that the difference between 50 and 47, that one is 3. What is the difference between 47 and 44? Will be 3. You will end up with the 3. The 3 being the difference between these terms. It will be clear now that to get the next term in the sequence, you always go on subtracting a 3. 50 minus 3, 47. 47 minus 3, 44 minus 3, 41 onwards. This is also very easy. Everybody out there can look at this and try to understand. Now, if you are getting the next numbers in the sequence, you will come and write 50, 47, 44, 41, 38. 38 minus 3 will give us 35. 35 minus 3 will come to 32. 32 minus 3 will bring you to 29. So you will have 100. The 63 comes in the sequence. The sequence can easily be answered by identifying which pattern is used. If the pattern used is square numbers that have been identified, so you look at which one is the next square number. Go to the next example. You may come to a case where we're talking about odd numbers, prime numbers. Look at this. If I look at this, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, it is. How many terms have been given? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These terms have been given. Here, there is no common difference. Because there is no common difference, you may not simply go on by adding. If you go on adding or subtracting, you may lose track. The difference here is 1. The difference here is 2. The difference here, you find, is also 2. The difference here is 4. There is no common difference. But if you try to look at these numbers properly, you can try to interpret. Reason why 1 is missed. Reason why 9 does not appear here. These ones have in common one property, that they all have two factors, the number and its square. 1 has two factors. 1, 2, and itself. 3 has 2 factors, 3 and itself. Likewise, 5 has 2 factors, 7 has 2 factors, 11 has 2 factors. What does this mean? This is a sequence of prime numbers. And you only have to go to the next prime number. And you come now to identify. If I write it 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, the next prime number is 13. Next prime number from here, 17. From 17, 19. So sequences are easier to handle if you try to look at the pattern that's being used. The regular way of getting to the next number is the one now. The regular way now is by looking at the next prime number. We may come to this. If I come to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, this is slightly, this differs from example where we have seen. In that, in this one, you are seeing 1 is included, 3 is there. 9 is there, which was not in the first one. What does this mean? This sequence is different from the one in the part C. How do they differ? The difference comes in by looking at the common property here. The common property or common behavior here is each of these numbers, when divided by 2, gives a remainder of 1. There is a remainder. If you divide by 2, there is a remainder. 3 by 2 is a remainder. 5 by 2 is a remainder of 1. That remainder of 1 when divided by 2 suggests that all these ones are odd numbers. And you definitely come to see that what is supposed to be here is a 13. From here, 15, we come to 17. And the answers will differ. 15 is not a prime number. We have not included it here, but it's an odd number we have included here. So when you talk about handling and finding the general rule, you need to identify the common behavior for these numbers, and then you go on to use them when asked again. You may find numbers which are fractions. Fractions, and then still you look at them in a way that you identify what is common. For example, I want us to look at an example where we have 1 out of 4. We have 4 out of 9. 9 out of 16. 16 out of 25. If you at all find the next term in this sequence, you may not look for the difference. The common difference may not be there. But if you try to look at this in comparison to that, this in comparison to that, and try to study, you will realize that in this very sequence, what is used applying as opposed to these square numbers? You can see 1 is a square number, 4 is a square number, the next square number 9, the next square number 16. And then, in all cases, what is seen here is what should come down here. So, we normally bring this one up and write the next square number. Bring it up, write the next square number. So, 25 now can be brought up and the next square number is 36. 36 is pushed up, the next square number is 49. 49 is pushed up, and the next square number is 64. So these answers can be both whether the terms are whole numbers or they appear in form of fractions. We may even have decimals. Decimals, we still have to look at them and identify what is common. I want you to look at this before I subject you to some of these examples in the learner's book. Look at the number where we have 4.1, 4.7, 5.3, 5.9. This one appears in your book. Next to this, you will come to look at 6.5. If you have looked for the next numbers in this sequence, you will realize that there is a common difference between them. The difference between 4.1 and 4.7 is 0.6 here. Is another 0.6. 0.6. So 0.6 is now the common difference. What does this mean? To get the next term, you add 0.6 and you can get as many as possible. So all in all, don't only expect whole numbers, don't only expect fractions. You may have this most, you can have it in any form, but still the same approach that can be taken. Sometimes we can generate our sequences. I want us now to look at the example. We can push down and go on. We can go on and see. In all these tables, the ones that you are seeing, we are still looking at the patterns that can be drawn using the table. But there are some numbers where you don't have to use the table. You only study by way of looking at common difference or sometimes common ratio. Let us go down the list and look at the this. All those tables, same format, a bit. Now getting to this, you may find a particular question where we are talking about multiples but he used the table to go on and find the number whose matcos have been displayed. Here I've talked about cases before sequence is given without the table, but in a little bit. Yes, here we are. Now, in that very table, we can see clearly that what is the number from the equation? Let us go down and first see the equation up. There we are. The equation says, two matcos of the number have been shaded on this number square. Because we are saying number square is a square having numbers from 1 up to 100, and all sides are equal now. These two matcos are seen. The first one is 65 and the other one is 91. And now we are saying two matcos have been shaded on this. What is the number? The number should be in such a way that 65 is the matcos of that number and 91 is also a matcos. How do we go about this? So 65 and then 91. The best way of doing this, if you have to understand, we can come and look at 65, look at 91. Use prime factors. This cannot be divided by 2. You cannot divide by 3. If you go on, you cannot divide by 5. This is divisible by 5. 91 is not divisible by 5. Then you go to the next prime number. The next prime number is 7. 65 cannot be divided by 5. You cannot again divide 91 by 7. We cannot use the 7 here. From 7, we can try 11. 11 is not possible. You cannot divide 65 by 11. You cannot divide 91 by 11. If you go on checking, you will realize that all of these numbers can be divided by 13. 65 by 13, you will come to see that this one will be giving you 5. 91 by 13 will give you 7. Now, nothing else is common. What do we have to say? The number 13 divides 65 divides 91 and is common to all. So 65 is the matcos of 13 and 91 is also the matcos of 13. So where the question says that what is the number, the answer is that the number is 13. So we can try to look at this. Much as it is not a sequence given, as you look at the table, at times we can see which one is the pattern. The next question there says, what is the 19th matcos of this number? 19th matcos of the number. Now, to get the 19th matcos of this number, because the number is in 13, you can list down from 13 and say 13, 26, 39, we now come to 52, 65, go on to 78, go on to 91. When you add here, you will have 104 etc. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, add up to where you come to the 19th matcos. that one is clear, the infinitesimal of the number we are talking about. You now take your time, whenever you are, at home, you are somewhere, add these other multiples and count up to the 19. The 19th multiple is the answer that is needed. Here we are. If you are talking about describing the general rule or finding the next term, examples have been given here and I've talked about them already. The solution is given. What I'm interested in is an exercise given. Let us go down and look at the exercise. There is the exercise where they say copy the following exercise and find the sequences in each case. In that very exercise, you will see that they said give the next three numbers. To give the next three numbers, you have to first of all study and get the pattern of the sequence. If you get the pattern of the sequence, it will be easy on your side. That is number one, they say next 53. In number two, they say copy each sequence and fill in the missing numbers. Number two, I may try to give you hints, some of you probably get confused. Number two, part A. Question two, part A. Where we have four. There is a dash. That is a missing number. Then 16. We go on to 32. And then a dash. This is a sequence. The first two terms have been given, the third one is missed out. The fourth is given, fifth is given, the sixth one is missing. Still, we can answer this by using the same way, the same treatment. Whether we try to look at, what is the relationship here? You clearly see that the relationship here, if you try to talk about they differ by 2, but these ones do not differ by 2. So the difference can be dropped. Because they differ by 2, the other ones do not differ by 2. Next, we are going to look at cases of behavior. They are not, this is a square number, it's not a square number. Square is not a square number. So we can rule out the idea of a square number. We now talk about multiple. When you try to look at this, multiply by 2, you get 4. Even here, you multiply by 2, you get 32. That means the idea will now be multiplying. That is the criteria. That is the pattern. Multiplying numbers by 2. And for sure, if you try to look at the numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 onwards. 1 times 2, we are here. 2 times 2 is here. You can look at 8 times 2, 16. 16 times 2, 32. What is missing here will be, try to look at 4 times 2 will give you 8. So what is here is 8. 32 times 2 will give us 64. And that means there we have six people. What does this mean? Sometimes you don't have to only look at whether they are multiples alone, whether they are square numbers. You have to examine each and everything and make a conclusion on which one should be the answer that the person can give. So that exercise, look at it properly. With you can have it on an individual basis. You may handle and connect to a friend and check out the results from your friend to see whether they match with what you have. We are ready for any of the comments, any of the questions. If you have any problem, please tell your parents. They can get to us. You send the question will be answered. Now, in whatever we are doing now, we need to understand that sometimes a person can generate a sequence. We can generate a sequence by ourselves. How can you generate a sequence? You can generate a sequence by using a formula, by using another criteria that for me, I'm looking for cube numbers. I'm looking for square numbers. I'm looking for multiples of 9. I'm looking for multiples of 11. You can use any criteria and see that this is the way I'm getting my terms in the sequence. Now, formula. How can we come to formula for generating a sequence? Generating a sequence. Here you can think of an unknown. Think of an unknown like A, like X, and use it. For instance, if I want to use a criteria for any number N, if I'm to generate a sequence and say, for me, I'm interested in the multiples of 3. Then the formula to use will be 3 n, because I'm now looking for multiples of 3. The sequence that will come out will based on the positions. The one which will come in position 1, I put n is equal to 1. The one which will come in position 2, that's the second term, I will put n is equal to 2. To get the third term, I will put n is equal to 3. To get the fourth term, I will put n is equal to 4. And this sequence can easily be generated. I will have 3 times 1, that is the first term. 3 times 2, that is the second term. 3 times 3, that is the third term. 3 times 4, that is the fourth term. And in the end of it, we shall say this is an infinite set. Here I will have 3, I will have 6, I will have 9, this is 12, and it continues. So I'm generating a sequence by all using the formula that I'm now looking at, multiplying counting numbers by 3. So to generate a sequence, in most cases, we need a formula. This formula may not be restricted to how many terms. We may have a formula with a number of terms, say n squared plus 2n minus 1. So we may have as many as possible. Look at this example. If I'm to generate a sequence using the formula, formula 2n squared plus 3. 2n squared plus 3. You will realize that I'm going to look at what is in position 1, the first term, the second term, the third term or onwards. To get the first term, I put n equal to 1. That is the first term. To get the second term, I put n equal to 2. So I will now have the first term as 2 times 1 squared plus 3. The second term will be 2 times 2 squared plus 3. The third term will be 2 times 3 squared plus 3 onwards. When I multiply here, 1 squared is 1 times 2, 2 plus 3, the first term is 5. I go to the second term. 2 squared is 4 times 2, 8 plus 3, that is 11. I go to the third term. 3 squared is 9 times 2, 18 plus 3, 21. And I can have as many as possible. So generating a sequence is easy. Try to look at which ones you are interested. If the interest is in squaring or looking for square numbers, you want to go home and look at the position that the first number squared, what do we get? Second number squared, what do we get? We shall have that as the formula. So if I'm interested in square numbers, the formula will be formula is n squared. If I'm interested in a sequence of square numbers, the formula is n squared. You may try to look at the even numbers, odd numbers. If I'm interested in even numbers, I will look at dividing by 2 and no remainder. If we try to look at in that very chart here, example where we say what sequence do you generate by using the following formula? By the way, we can say formula if there are many, or you can also do English for persons say formula. But the best way is using formula. So now what we are being given there, whenever you are at home, try out and use for part A where we have 5n minus 1. You put in to get the first term, use n is equal to 1. To get the second term, use n is equal to 2. The third term, use n is equal to 3. Just put in these positions and get those terms. Then another part there where we have 6n plus 2. Since we generate the sequence here, go home and think about the positions. The first term, n is equal to 1. Second term, n is equal to 2. The third, n is equal to 3. You can have n is equal to 4 and continue with the same approach. These answers can be good. I want us to go down the list and see the solutions to some of these numbers given, but they need your input. You can try to look at what is indicated. You can also find the formula for a sequence, because this is finding the sequence using the formula. But you can use any given sequence to find which one is the formula. To find which one is the formula that is being used to generate these terms. You need to understand that we shall continue updating you with whichever exercise you can get from there. Also, these lessons will be coming following one after the other. We shall look at the approach you can use when finding the formula. It may take us some steps, but those steps we shall try to discuss them and try to look at how I can look at the given sequence and identify where is the position supposed to be and which others are these numbers that have been included. Most of these numbers will stand for the difference and then what can be added. This I will try to make clear. Now, I want to summarize by telling you the fact that all those numbers that have been given, you can try, we can get your solutions, and then give you the feedback. That exercise is for you to handle. The exercise is interesting, but I want us to... that exercise, where we have those numbers, let us continue. Those numbers still try out the exercise. We go down. There is another one there where number three is here. Write down the first five terms of the sequences given by each of the formulae. Those ones have been given. And please, I want to say, do not relax. When you look at an exercise, don't just imagine. Get an exercise book, get a pen, try out. Some of these numbers, you will see them coming out, and then get happy that really you have made it. In the next discussion, we shall look at how to get the formula. Don't get worried, try that one out. I will take you through the steps we can take when finding out the formula for any given sequence. Just want to wish you nice time when doing that exercise. We shall continue with these lessons one following another. Nice time to you.